filming the Chi-Town Down for Life documentary part two. And as we ride through the hood, this rainy day, we just reflecting on some of the things that we done seen, all the different type of memorials we done went to. You know, it's kind of sad, you know, seeing, you know, families grieve over violence in the hoods of Chicago. You know, it's kind of sad, you know. But, you know, as we focus on some of the drama that goes on, we also focus on some of the positive things that Chicago has to bring. And some might say it's not that much, but it is. You know, it's thriving businesses. You know, we just gotta we gotta come together. You know what I'm saying? And this is just all race. You know, it's not just blacks. You know, it's just a sad situation. You know, but. It is what it is, you know, Chicago, you know. So as we continue to film through the city of Chicago, you know, hopefully this change your life. Hopefully this change your outlook. This change how you feel. You know, Chicago is a great city. And we just gonna keep repping Chicago the right way. And bringing a positive light on Chicago. You know, this is the life. This is Chi-Town Down for Life.
All this shit is fucked up though. Shorties really need to calm down around this motherfucker. They just like, it's like shit we did when we was growing up, we did for real. Like it was like, it was real live shit. Like gangbanger was coming up, you know what I'm saying? And the drugs was selling, so that's what we sold it, to make money and shit.
Right.
But now these shorties out here, they hustling for jeans and shit like that. You know what I'm saying? Like, like if you out here hustling for jeans, you already lost. If you risking your freedom for some damn jeans or something. If
true,
you if this money ain't making you enough money to get a car and pay like some rent or some shit like that, then you out here foolish as hell. But it's all about the music now, and us grown niggas, we ain't saying shit to these shorties. You know what I'm saying?
Right.
We making their lifestyle seem like this where it's at and shit, and shit just clownish. Like, this how you know it's just some shorty shit and they just turned up too much, because how the fuck just killing always happened just on the weekend?
Right.
Back in the day, if it was
Friday and Saturday.
Back
Sunday.
In the day. You looking for a nigga, you ain't just gonna wait till the weekend to get him.
Right.
But it's just cause these shorties teeing up so hard to the point it just go down right then and there, cause they just out listening to the music and shit. And I know Chief Keef didn't see this shit coming with this lifestyle he brought, you know what I'm saying? I ain't gonna put no say shit bad about him, cause he was just trying to do his thing, make some money. But boy, it fucked these shorties head up. Mm-hmm. And they got them on some type of high that they can't even come down from now.
It's because the younger guys don't have any structure anymore, man. Like, ain't, there's no chiefs out here to get these little brothers organized, keep them in school. Because, you know, when I was coming up, the chiefs on the block and the older guys made sure you went to school, made sure you was doing something. And then these niggas out here ain't even getting no money in these areas. They shooting and killing niggas up. Like, I'm from out west. Where I was from, if you want to fuck with us getting money over here, then, like, who really cared? Like, if it was, like, we'll beef with you if you fucking with our 20 grand, 30 grand a week spot. But these motherfuckers out here selling nickel louds, and they killing motherfuckers because I live on Manistee and you live on Escanaba, so we gonna shoot and kill each other. And we done went to grammar school together, be hooping at the same parks, be hollering at the same bitches, but we killing each other just because we live on opposite blocks. It ain't worth it, bro. Right. These motherfuckers out here dying. And then, I wouldn't even have a problem with you shooting a motherfucker you had beef with him, whatever he did to you, that's your problem. But go get that person. Don't go shoot up the corner, you got eight other innocent people standing out there next to that nigga or shooting up laundromats innocent people and they're doing laundry with their kids. Motherfuckers just reckless. Like, you think you're a gangster, but people don't understand gangsters have rules and laws they live by. No women and kids and no innocent people. Go walk up on a nigga and get him. That's basically what it is. You gonna kill him off or go ahead? I don't know what he did to you, what he for him to deserve that shit. That's y'all business. But don't kill no innocent man who ain't got shit to do with. That's my only issue, what's going on out here.
It's fucked up. Ain't no love up in the city. It was 60 people shot in 3 days. Where we from, that's the reality. Niggas strapped cause they gotta be. Getting rid of weight without a calorie shit. Drug dealing pay a salary. And that's Chicago. That's how it is. It's fucked up on these streets. But you know, you gotta survive through it. You gotta know how to move. Be smooth. The shorty's going crazy out here, you know. Eight generation, wilding out, but you get a lot older, man, you know, just fall back from a lot of shit. And just, you know, we done did all that. We made it through, so now it's y'all time. You know, God bless all the little homies, though, man. They ass, boy, they going crazy.
What would you say to the shorties coming up, man? What would you say to them?
Man, stay focused, man. Just, you know, I mean, I can't say don't have your gun and shit, you know what I'm saying? And then I tell you don't have your gun, you go outside. Five other niggas around you that you into it with got guns, and that's the crazy shit happens. That's how fucked up it is, but stay focused, man. Do you stay low-key? If you know you got a bunch of bullshit going on, be low-key, man. Don't bring your kids around this shit, none of that shit. You gotta keep it neat, man. Stay focused, man. Straight up.
Violent weekend in Chicago has left 11 people dead and 60 wounded in shootings across the city. Chicago Police Superintendent Gary McCarthy is addressing the issue as well as recently seized firearms at this hour. Fox 32's political editor Mike Flannery is live with more. Michael?
Well, Corey, Police Superintendent Gary McCarthy is still speaking inside the 10th District Police Station here on the west side at Ogden and Christiana. He says that the Chicago police had a plan over this bloody 4th of July weekend. Nonetheless, as you indicated, Corey, there was a count of casualties that could have been from Afghanistan or Iraq, but it was here in Chicago, a place some have dubbed Chirac. The most interesting aspect of this, as we have seen so many times, there were literally a small handful of shootings on the north side, four on the north side, and police say in Englewood alone, one neighborhood on the south side, there were three times as many, and the police superintendent is chalking that up to guns. He says if he is asked about the biggest difference between Chicago and New York City, where he grew up and where he was a cop for 20 years, he said it is the proliferation of guns. The police superintendent also addressed the fact that there were apparently 8 police officers who discharged their weapons or who had themselves fired upon by offenders. The police superintendent, again, rattling off all of the details of these incidents, in many cases the offenders, felons, some out on parole, some out on bond. And these offenders, the police superintendent indicated, should not have been on the street. He said many of these incidents should not have happened at all because the suspects in those incidents should have been in the county jail or in state prison. Corey, back to you.
They say I shouldn't talk about this type of thing. You know, they say it don't sell records. And you gonna lose your listeners. But you know what I say?
How many children got to die before we wake up? How many jobs we gotta lose before we break up? How many fathers gonna be gone from their children?
Man up, man up, man up.
Tell them the streets gonna raise them to be hoodlums. Please, please, somebody give me an answer. Please, please, tell me why they don't care for an answer.
Why did you have to kill him?
Please,
we can only come together. We can solve somebody
love every day.
Please,
please,
tell me why that rap preaching and teaching.
Nice block out here, we out here chilling, getting
big
money.
Big old XD.
We out here every day.
Hold up, look at who here. We come one of our boys, Zion, and Slickin'.
What's up, nigga?
What's up, nigga? What's up,
folks
right
there.
How you
doing? Shot time down for
life, baby.
Yes, sir. Welcome
yes, sir.
To 42nd and
Campbell.
Thank you for having me out here,
baby.
How this
block in the city?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
What you talking about?
Yo!
King Killer, bitch ass nigga, die five.
All right, right.
Four, five, die, bitch.
SD, bitch. 42nd Camel, nigga. SD World. Ready, know what it is, bitch.
Yes, sir,
we
yes,
got
sir.
Big bangs over here, bitch. Come get you some, nigga.
Oh, here comes the monster truck.
Here, the monster.
Hey, here comes the monster
truck. Out here, 42 Camel.
Bitch. Come get you some, nigga.
Yes, sir.
You know how we 13'd out, baby.
Gangsta 2-6 killer, bitch. You know what that is. You know what that is, nigga. 2-6 killer, bitch.
Crack halos, everything. Big devils, baby. You know what it is. 4200.
Crack crowns, nigga. You know what's up, bitch. Count killer, nigga. King killer. AK, bitch. Rockside killer.
Come hit us, baby. Come hit us,
nigga.
Hit us. Nigga,
what's up, nigga?
Too long, bitch. What's up? We just going at it with everybody, oppositions, you know what I'm saying?
Right.
We fighting over nothing, to be honest with you.
Right.
So, motherfucker pull up right now, we get the slugging at somebody right,
right
now. Just cause we standing on this block.
Bishop killer.
42nd is well known to be hated. All y'all 38s, all y'all 47, the damers know what the fuck it is. Stop tricking.
Our body ain't nobody but a dead body, nigga. Cypho world, bitch.
Cypho world, nigga. Look,
we
got big rappers over here, boy.
It's different right here. This ain't the black side right here. We don't fight over drugs. We fight over colors and banging. We did before. We're gonna
slug your bitch ass face. Remember my face, bitch. Remember my face, bitch. 42 Campbell Street.
Dennis, you a bitch, nigga. Come hey, come holla at me, nigga. What's up, nigga?
D-Lo, bitch. 40 and what for what, nigga? Y'all ain't on shit.
Little Chucky D, man.
Was crazy. I mean, we've already had 5 people shot earlier this afternoon out here. We gotta stop this madness. You know, that's why we have things like this. At block parties, we have over 1,000 people here tonight. Come through, eat food, enjoy each other. This is what it's about. If every block, all through the city, we do it every Friday night, just come out. You don't have to have food, have to cook, whatever. Just come out, be with each other on your block. Let's occupy the streets. Let's occupy our neighborhoods and turn this thing around. If not, we just go from weekend to weekend with new numbers adding up, and it's got to stop.
Why does it seem like you're the only one that's really out here trying to make this thing happen? It seems like it's like no one but you, you know?
Well, you know, I can't worry about what anybody else is or is not doing. I got to do what I'm going to do. But I just know I hear a lot of people talking, do something. Even the people that criticize me and say, well, you know, flag of this, flag of that. Just do your own thing. You don't have to talk about me. Just do your thing. We are out here every Friday night. This Friday we're block party. Other Friday we're marching. Then we'll have more block parties. We out here doing something. And we're going to try to do the best we can. That's all I can worry about. All I can give my energy. I can't give my energy to people hating on me. That's their problem.
Okay. And last question. What do we need to do to stop this violence? What do we need to do?
Well, if we're going to stop the violence, we got to understand this is a major comprehensive issue. We got to get jobs. We've got to get good schools. We've got to get alternatives, economic development, parenting, blocks coming together, churches getting out in the street. So it's everybody doing something, you know. So until we really want to all come together and fight for all of that at the same time, we're going to keep going from weekend to weekend. And the truth of the matter is, we can do it. It's not whether we can, it's whether we have the will.
Right. Thank you. Thank you so much.
Thank you, sir.
Okay, one more second.
We shall overcome.
Right.
We shall overcome. Town Down for Life TV, man. We here with the young man Andrew. You know, he always telling everybody to put the guns down. He's very in the community all the time, so we just want to get a word from him, man, and just let everybody know, like, how you feel about this current situation of all this violence going on in Chicago, and what we need to do to stop the violence in Chicago.
Well, most of all, we're asking Bob to step up and go back home. You know, no matter whether you're with your kids or you're not with your kids, we want you to go back home and get your kids, whether they're male or female. But most of all, we're tired of having joyful weekend, and then the next weekend we have a family reunion at the cemetery. You know, and that's what's going on.
Okay. And like, what do you think we need to do to stop the violence? What do you think we need to do?
You know, start being more parents at home, you know, and at the same time, you know, reach one, teach one. You know, you see one out here, it might not be your child, but at the same time, go to that young man and step to that young man and just tell him, you know, teach him how to dress. Teach him, you know, how to be a man, teach him how to grow up, because see, the only thing that's being taught out here to them, they run to the corner and they just been talking game, like, that ain't what it's about. Most of all, the man can step to a young man and give him some courage and enhance his quality of life. Talk to him and put him back in church. Put him somewhere where he ain't never been. Instead of putting a gun in his hand, put the Bible in his hand and let him reach himself from there. And I guarantee you, that young man will be saved.
Thank you so much.
Oh, without a doubt, man.
Thank you. Your real brother right here, y'all. Without a doubt.
Every life matters. Every single life matters. And the youth that are looking, yeah, right now, your life matters.
Exactly.
The generation that you're living in right now,
matters.
Half of you are already gone.
Yep.
Because they didn't recognize that their life mattered enough not to pick up a gun. Your life matters. Take advantage of the opportunity to live.
And the actions of hatred on a family, generationally, is ever present. I have to say that. I'm 2.5 years out from my daughter being murdered. And it cuts today like it did 2.5 years ago. I just have a desire to live. That's why I'm out here in these streets doing what I do. But don't do that to nobody else. Your life matters. Somebody loves you.
Thank you so much. Thank you so much. What's up, man? We with your homie, man, Young God the Great.
Yeah, man.
You know what I'm talking about? You know what I'm saying? You repping that West Side. We out here
16th and Ridgeway. You know what I'm saying? Let them know, man. What's happening? What's cracking out here?
Man, yo, a lot of bullshit, but main thing I do, stay out the way, get my money, and survive, yo.
That's what's up. That's what's up. What make this side different from any other side in Chicago?
Man, yo, we about to get money out here. We ain't with all that gangbang and shit. And we rap, try to find a better way to get by every day.
Okay, okay. All right. And music-wise, you know what I'm saying? Like, you know what I'm saying? What you got coming out? What you dropping or, you know what I'm saying?
Yeah, I'm trying to do my little mixtape, whatever. Holy City Rap Soul Music.
Yeah.
Gonna be crack. Gonna be a hit.
Man, that Chicago joint is on fire, man. You know what I'm saying? It's on this documentary. You know what I'm saying? So we gonna hold you down.
All right.
You know what I'm talking about?
Yeah,
we gonna hold you down. So. What's up? Like, where everybody go at around here, though? Like, what's, you know?
You see the liquor store right here is where everybody be at. But back in the day, we had this. It was A1, but it closed down because there was so much traffic right there.
Okay.
And then that was, like, downtown. You come out west, that's where you had to go to.
Right.
George Music Room next.
Right.
Shut that shit down, so, man.
Dang.
It's dry around this motherfucker, so you got to find something to do or be a goner.
Right. All right. We out here in the middle of it, man.
Yeah, right.
See, take the rings, bro. That's what's up. That's what's up. Rubbing that Chi-Town down for life, man. I appreciate you for getting on camera, man.
Yeah, man. Thanks. No problem.
All right. Okay, as far as the violence, what do we need to do to get this to stop? You know what I'm saying? Like, no, it seems like nobody don't have a solution. Like, what solution can we think of to make all this stop? Can it stop? Will it ever stop?
I mean, it can stop, but I mean, it starts with the media. It starts with, you know what I'm saying, what you see. I mean,
And what you put out.
You know what I'm saying? What you give is what you get every time. Mm-hmm. You know what I mean? So I really feel like it starts with, you know what I'm saying, the medias that we get. I mean, you know what I'm saying? I'm a fan of rap music. I'm a fan of hip hop. You know what I mean? But look at what it's become now. You know what I'm saying? Chief Keef and them, you know what I'm saying? Not to, you know, pass no blame, but you know what I'm saying? That's the first name you think of. This gang rap, you know what I mean? It ain't doing.
You can't really blame music, though. You can't really blame music. You know what I'm saying? I listen to music. I listen to all that. I ain't out here killing nobody.
I'm not really blaming the music. It's more
what they put out. You know what I'm saying? It's what they put out.
The message that they bring.
They put out that all you gotta do is sell drugs, fuck hoes, smoke weed, shoot people. So the people listen to it, they put it in their ear. That's all they wanna do. They listening to your music and not listen to your lyrics. They talk about the same thing. They talk about killing each other. How I'ma fuck this bitch and that bitch a thot and sell drugs and I was born rich. Nobody was born rich unless your parents are already rich. Now one of these rappers I know that is rich, but what's gonna change is money. We need more money coming in. We need more, like I said earlier, we need more black owned businesses. We need things that we can circulate within our people, because the white people is doing it. They circulate their money. The Jewish people, they circulate their money. They keep their money in their society. We give our money away, huh? Here goes some money. We need to keep our money and circle it around and put it in our community, in our city, and generate more money for these upcoming brothers like him and older brothers like my little brother. We need something for them to do, because they're bored. They be like, man, I ain't got no job. I always want to smoke weed. I got some hoes. I want to do this. I'm going to do nothing else. And they don't want to get a job because there is no jobs. They want to, all they can do is rob people, try to take their life, shoot people, take their life. They're doing nothing but negative things instead of positive things. So that we're going to change. Money. Money is all, they say money is the root of all evil, but money is what's going to save Chicago.
Man, I'm on the Looney Gang, man. I'm one of the BDs, man, from Detroit, man. Trickertown shit, man. I'm Looney Gang, you welcome, man.
Trickertown shit, man. My
team's
out there.
Okay. What y'all think about all this violence out here, though, man?
Too much. You know what I think? I think us black folks, we shouldn't kill each other. I think we should stand together.
Okay.
Because these white motherfuckers out here and these police,
they stand together.
Let's now I know if we retaliate,
if we retaliate,
the white people got
arsenals. Mm-hmm.
They do.
They got arsenals.
They want us
they
to retaliate.
They got holes dug and everything. They ready for this shit to go down. We ain't
so
ready.
They want to put us in the
camps.
We
don't keep it real.
They want to put us in
the
camps.
Let's keep it real. It really came from the motherfuckers over the motherfuckers that's really out here doing the dumb shit now.
It comes from the white man, trained, but it comes from us too, because guidance only comes from the home. Mm-hmm. You see what I'm saying? If the people we got in the home ain't got the right guidance, it's certain times in life that you like, we got the white man that's hard on the man itself, so the man itself can't kick it with the lower person, so the lower person can't get the guidance they need, mm-hmm, because the older man got to stay up out the streets. Right. You see what I'm saying?
Well, you know what I got to say about that? Like, if you put a lot of people in a maze, they can only go the way the maze go.
Right.
So I don't think it's the household. I think it was all designed that way.
Okay.
To make the household that way.
Right.
So you got to go to the root of the problem.
And if you said you was following something, then they would have followed the way that the old timers did it.
Right.
We don't kick in doors and kill people's mamas. We don't shoot when little kids outside. We don't shoot when little kids outside. That's if you was following our woman, then our woman is real. We don't shoot when little kids outside. Right. We get our man. We walk dead up on our man and get our man. Mm-hmm. That's it. That's all. That's a real nigga. If you got a problem with a man, go get your man. Leave these little kids and shit out of. Go get your man, though. Walk right up on him and get him.
Really want to look at it, we got a lot of niggas that walk like a duck, quack like a duck, but just ain't a duck.
Right.
You feel what I'm saying?
Right.
So in that simple fact like that, you got some of them that's trying to take a road that ain't made for them. You see what I'm saying? When that road ain't made for them, they don't got nothing to do but fail. Because they don't even know, they don't got the tools and the education to go down that road. So motherfuckers need to stay in their lane and figure out where they coming and know where they going. Because you never know where you're going until you know where you come from. Real talk.
There you go.
Now, to my understanding, the names at the top is the family names. Then the names as the yellow is everybody that they done lost out here. Some to violence and some just people that stay out here, you know, that just was out here for a long time. Let's see if I can find my homie on this wall, because I know they put him up there.
For those who don't know, where we at right now?
Argyle Gardens, man. A lot of people call it 3130. You know, home of the infamous garden right
there. And what can you find this wall at? Where is this wall located at?
131st and Ellis. Right now we at up top at the store, at up top. Up top. Yup. It's slimy in here, man. Slimy in here, but you can make it anywhere if you got the right mindset. Don't let your element become what you are. I'm a living proof of that, man. Felony, all that. Gang member, all that. But it's how you choose to live that's gonna get you longevity in this life. You know they killing every day, and you wanna live, shit, do the right thing. It don't hurt. Or you gonna end up like this, a name on the wall. A memory that people will forget about 2 or 3 weeks. You know, everybody say they love you when you die, but the ones that really love you is the ones that's pushing you to do better for yourself while you're living. So just take heed to that. It's real. It's real. Dwayne Clay, I had just met him like 2-3 years ago. I've been staying out here 5 years, Dwayne Clay. You know what I'm saying? Lost him to the street violence. There's a lot of people out here, man.
Argyle Gardens, huh?
Argyle Gardens, man.
In honor of all the young men and women shot and killed in Chicago, we would like to dedicate this segment to them, the Put the Guns Down segment. Shout out to everybody who came out and took a picture to support the cause. I really appreciate y'all. Chicago, check the segment out. And again, please put the guns down. It's been too hard.
but I'm afraid to die. 'Cause I don't know what's up there beyond the sky. It's been a long time coming, but I know a change won't come. Somebody keep telling me don't hang around. It's been a long time coming, but I know a change gonna come. Oh, yes, it will. Then I go to my brother. I say, brother, help me, please. But he winds up knocking me back down on my knees. Oh, there have been times. But I know a change gon' come.